6 now, the Trump-Iran disinformation campaign, judging by its recent reporting, the mainstream media seems to be almost goading the Trump administration into war with Iran. Witness this incredibly inflammatory report. And the president responding to the so-called infighting among his team over Iran, the fake news Washington Post and even more fake news New York Times are writing stories that there is infighting with respect to my strong policy in the Middle East. There is no infighting whatsoever. The truth is the Iranian regime is probably infighting, suffering greatly under the Trump maximum pressure campaign. But what is the reality here? Where is this headed short-term, long-term? Joining me now, the founder of the American Truth Project and Daily Ledger contributor, Barry Nussbaum. Barry, the president obviously doesn't want war with Iran. He wants freedom for the Iranian people. Now, the Saudis, on the other hand, seem to be rattling sabers. They're rattling U.S. sabers, almost egging the administration on for some sort of limited military action in Iran.
The parallels, Graham, between today, 2019, and 1938 and 1939 are terrifyingly similar. Adolf Hitler made no secret that his goal was to conquer the world. He publicized it, he talked about it frequently, and here we are in the next century where the leaders of Iran are talking the same thing. Huge difference. Adolf Hitler had conventional weapons and a number of generals that in their memoirs after the war said, if Britain and France and the Allies had stood up to Hitler in 1938, the generals would have killed Hitler. The difference is nuclear weapons with delivery systems capable of turning the world into a parking lot. Iran every day talks about destroying the United States, Israel, Saudi Arabia, and anybody that doesn't want to go along with their program. And now they've crossed the line. At least two, possibly three tankers have been attacked, severely damaged. Saudi oil pipelines have been blown up by drone strikes. And get this, Iran's making no secret about the fact that they did it. So the question is, do we appease like Britain did in 1938 that led to the war that almost destroyed the world? Or do we stand up to this thuggery before there's a war the likes of which the world has probably never seen?
Well, one thing's
good
for sure.
Good job by Trump for standing up.
Yeah, one thing's for sure, Barry, we can't let Iran get the bomb. And we know that the Obama-Iran nuke deal helped facilitate that. So we need to know exactly what stage they are in terms of developing a nuclear weapon. Speaking of the Obama administration, the leaker, James Comey, is out there leaking again, only this time he's doing it in a fashion to CYA, right? So he's throwing Brennan under the bus regarding the Trump dossier because he knows who's breathing down his neck. It's the Attorney General and the Attorney General's investigation.
These investigations launched by Bill Barr, actually surreptitiously some time ago, have the rats literally turning on each other as they're trying to get off the bad boy ship that was put together under the Obama administration and Hillary Clinton's leadership at state. There is some serious criminality being investigated, I don't think the likes of which the American public has seen in 100 years. There's some really bad stuff out there, and these people are going to turn on each other, Graham, and it's going to get worse before it gets better. Comey and all of those people, Clapper and so on from National Intelligence, the FBI, the Attorney General's office, apparently they're all involved, and everybody's starting to point the finger at everybody else. Isn't that really curious? I can't wait to see Bill Barr's report coming out.
Comey is in trouble. And he knows he's in trouble. And if you notice, just over the last couple, 3 weeks, maybe a month, his demeanor has changed. He was running around the country, signing and selling books. Now, all of a sudden, he's changed his tune because he knows what's coming. At the very least, he's probably guilty of violating the Federal Records Act. At the very most, he's probably at the tip of the spear of this conspiracy to try and prevent Donald Trump from winning the 2016 presidential election. Barry, thanks.